Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue the trap series right here at BusyWorksBeats.com/trap. Today I'm going to show you how to make your melodic trap more exciting. And these are small little tricks, but these small little tricks are going to send you to that next level. Again, it's not always some huge change that's going to make you sound better. It's always little small things. So the first thing with your trap beats is that a lot of people let their 808s ring all the way out. So for example, where's our 808? I always lose the 808. Where's it at? Here's our 808, I think. Okay, so here, let me clone this. Actually, we don't need to clone it. Use the fade out parameter is my point. Okay, so here's, let me copy this and let's reset it. So here's the 808 naturally. Now it's fine, but it kind of eats up the whole space for the artist. So what I like to use is the fade out parameter. Now keep in mind, the fade out is different than creating a custom envelope. I'm not going to get into all that, but because fade out does a linear fade from the beginning, it doesn't just do it at the end. So it's fading all the volume from the beginning. So let's paste that value back in and run it through the same effects. It just makes the 808 a little more bouncy and playful for dance music. So the first trick is just cutting the length of your 808. A lot of people let it ring all the way out and it makes it too boomy and not enough groove. So the second trick here is to do short sprint chords, and a lot of people are overly doing the melody in their beat. You have to remember the vocalist is a melody and it's a huge part of the melody. It is the main melody that people will remember. So a lot of people are trying to create melodies inside the beat and you're forgetting that a person has to sing over top the track. So what I did here was simple chords, but I didn't use any melodic elements, but I made it feel like a melody by the playing style. So simply E minor and then F major. Two chords. But the trick is that I strummed the chords, but then also I added the swing parameter almost all the way up. So it adds an extra kind of flicker of the notes. And that makes it feel like we're playing a melody, but we're really not, we're just playing a chord. It's kind of like chewing gum, kind of gives you the sensation that you're eating food, but you're really not eating food. Okay, so those chords will leave the canvas foundation for the melody, but you're not overly making stuff melodic inside the beat. Again, overkill is so easy when it comes to adding melodies to the beat. Don't overkill your beat with a bunch of melodies inside the beat. Just always remember, an artist is going to add the melody. That's the point of them getting in the track. Okay? And another trick, well, that is the trick, I kind of jumped ahead of myself, which is to have no melody in the beat. Again, we producers want to hear it all done all at once sometimes, and we will overcompensate. We will add brass, whereas brass can fight against the vocal. We'll add sawtooth waves, which will fight against the vocal. We'll do all this stuff because subconsciously we want to hear the vocal in the track, so we overly compensate for that missing element, and then we overkill the beat. So again, I cannot like emphasize that enough. You're probably adding way too many melodic things in your beat. Last trick here is just to start using swing on trap beats. Now, I'm at 140 BPM, so swing is a lot different at 140 BPM than it is at 88 BPM, because at 88, you're gonna hear the notes back to back a lot differently than you will at 140 BPM. So let me demonstrate this with a hi-hat. So here's 140 swing. Whereas if we're at 88, let me copy this value. Oops. And let's go down to like 80 BPM. It gives you a whole different vibe. Sounds amateur-esque, but if we use that at a high BPM. Also, it's evident in notes which are right next to each other. So for this in this case, here's another kind of sub trick I learned from a Chop Squad DJ. You highlight a note, you drag it out, and then hit Alt A, and then you change your time multiplicator. Multiplicator, just sounds weird saying that. And then I do this every time I want to hear that swing effect. I don't want to hear the swing effect all the way through, but it makes hi-hat rolls sound better. So here's without swing. Period. Let's reset. It's fine the way it is, but with swing, it adds a little more bounce, okay? So you can only hear that when you have the notes right next to each other, okay? So that's my whole point. But while you're at 140 BPM, the notes aren't, you're not gonna be programming notes right next to each other. So the only time that happens is with a hi-hat roll, for example. That's why I created that hi-hat roll, to illustrate the swing. And the only other place you hear the swing is between notes which are close to each other, which is the chord. Just adds a different timing, a different groove. It feels completely different. Out like a light, in the front, yeah, with the dun, yeah, with the bounce, I be down like a light. So a lot of, so I don't want you to overlook swing. It can make your track sound like Drake versus an amateur track. So anyway, if you want to continue the FL Studio, actually the Trap series, go to busyworksbeats.com/trap. Again, you get these project files for free with the link below. Just click that link. Totally free to download. Thanks for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com.